What is going on, Sales Dev Squad? Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of the Sales Dev Squad podcast. It's your host, Mateo Elvira, here back with another episode. We got a super special guest for you today. We have a retired NFL athlete, a sales development leader over at Sixth Sense, a prospecting coach. He has played on teams such as the Minnesota Vikings, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and suddenly transitioned his career into sales development. A lot of great posts on LinkedIn. You guys should definitely check them out. We have Ernest Owusu on today. Ernest, thanks so much for taking some time. I know you just had triplets not too long ago amidst a pandemic, but nonetheless, how are you?
I'm doing great. And first, thank you so much for having me. I think all things considered, having triplets, the pandemic, a lot of stuff going on in the world, feeling pretty happy, loving what we're doing at Sixth Sense, and really have no complaints.
Nice. And you're still in the Bay Area right now?
That's correct. Yeah, I've been out. So I came out here for school. Went to UC Berkeley, Cal, where I played football. And honestly, just after coming out here, I've loved the Bay Area so much, I just couldn't leave.
Dude, wonderful, man. Well, I just want to hop into it because I'm so interested. You're the only person in tech that I've seen that has been in the NFL, which I can't believe I'm talking to an NFL player right now. But walk us through that, man. Like, did you always know you wanted to play professional sports? Obviously, like you played in at Berkeley, but do you mind just like walking us through like maybe briefly like that portion of your life?
Yeah, sure. And it was really cool. So my parents are I'm first generation. My parents came from Ghana, which is in West Africa. And honestly, from a sports perspective, I didn't really know I was gonna start playing football or at least take it seriously until high school. And then honestly, I just kept getting bigger and stronger and started getting a lot better. And before I knew it, I started getting some scholarships and I had the opportunity to play at Cal. And honestly, I chose Cal because I wanted to go to a great school with a great academic program, athletic program. And that's kind of why I made that decision. But it didn't start becoming a lot more apparent for me that the NFL dream was going to become a reality. And so probably like my junior year or so, a lot of kind of how I've done things from a sales development perspective, as well as even, as an athlete is refine your craft, make yourself as good as possible as you possibly can get. And like kind of all things will fall in place. But so I'm not always like as focused on the end result. I just want to get better and be really good at what I do. And I started to realize in college that I was getting good enough to the point where some teams were showing interest in me and I knew it was going to be a possibility. And I kind of just started improving a lot at a high rate and before I knew it was in the NFL. And honestly, it was a dream come true. It was something that like once I realized it was a possibility, I was like over the moon thrilled to get to be a part of organizations with like some Hall of Famers and to be a part of those experiences. It's something that I'll never forget for the rest of my life. And the cool thing about it is a lot of people don't really realize it, but with what I'm currently doing as a sales development leader, there are so many ways, so many connections into what makes you successful sales development rep as well as leader as to what makes you a great athlete, especially a professional athlete. And I take that with me as a badge of honor in terms of what I've done and built all the teams around it, and it's been a lot of fun doing so.
Dude, I don't want to like go too deep into NFL because you're a sales leader and that's why we have you on the podcast. But like, for most people, they won't get the opportunity to like get drafted and be on a real NFL field with a real NFL jersey. Like, what was that experience like when like you were selected to join like a NFL team? Like, just walk us through like what's going on in your head at that moment.
Yeah, so honestly, again, I'm usually more focused on what I'm doing as opposed to the end result. But I will say the moment where I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this was it was my first preseason game with the Vikings. We were playing against the 49ers at Candlestick, the old stadium. And I remember being on the sideline, the first time wearing my jersey, first time I'm suited up to play a game. And I started playing the national anthem and I just started crying. Because it was just like this most like surreal moment of like, wow, like how did I get here? Like I can't believe that all the work that I've done has kind of finally put me in this place where I'm like literally on the field in an awesome city where I played college at with a team I've always wanted to play for, and I just can't believe I'm going to do this. So it was really surreal to be in that moment, but honestly, I was always more focused on like the development of my skills, so I didn't really think about that as much, but that moment in particular kind of really struck a chord with me.
Thank you so much for that. I'm just really curious to hear your perspective on that. But I guess like after that sort of chapter of your life, Ernest, how did you like even consider or like get to think that like tech sales or like tech sales leadership is something you wanted to do? Like, how did you even hear about like that sector, that space?
Yeah, so it's actually kind of funny. So I remember after my first off season, as I mentioned, I started coming out to the Bay Area and just almost made this my home after going to Cal and living out here. But I remember one Saturday, I was going to visit some friends in San Francisco. I remember walking downtown and walking past the Salesforce Tower, not Salesforce Tower, one of Salesforce's buildings. And just kind of, I knew of the brand. So something that I was always just familiar with. And I was like, I can imagine that when this is all said and done, I'm probably going to work at a tech company because that'd be like super cool to be done, to be doing after I finish playing football. So I kind of always had this like vision that I'd get into tech just being out in the Bay Area. And honestly, the reason why I chose sales in particular is because I like one of the things that I'm always focused on is like really understanding what your strengths and weaknesses are and like winning with your strengths. Like I have certain skill sets that got me to the NFL. So like, what was it that got me there and kind of how could I take that into my next career? And I like really like, wrote it down, like in terms of my work ethic, in terms of skill development, the things that got me there. And I took that and started talking to people and started to realize like, what can I do that's helped me be successful in the past and parlay into my next role? And repeatedly sales just kept coming up. And, you know, at that point I was like, all right, you know, if a lot of people who have a good understanding of what my skill set is are telling me it's a good area to go, it's something that I didn't think about in college. Obviously I was very focused on, you know, reaching to the NFL level. Let me at least explore this. And once I kind of realized that this is where I wanted to be, I just kind of dove headfirst into the interview process. And throughout all of that, I just loved it more and more. And then I started to realize that, like, you know, now that I'm done playing football, sales is going to be my next football. Like, I want to be as great as I possibly can at sales. And I want to, like, perfect my craft every single day from when I was an SDR to an AE to a sales development leader. And I'm really happy that I was able to figure that out. Through a lot of help from other people at an earlier stage in my career, because this is exactly what I've wanted to do. It's a lot of NFL players really struggle with trying to find their next career afterwards because we love playing football so much. But like, again, this is so similar to playing football, and it's been a dream to kind of step into this seamlessly and have a lot of success as well.
Dude, that's awesome, man. I guess, like, I know that you mentioned earlier, see a lot of similarities. Like, how can SDRs change their perspective into like training the way maybe like an NFL player or an athlete for that matter? Like, what is some advice that you can share with our audience here, like how we can get reps thinking about training? Because obviously, like, you're an athlete, you had to train your mind, body, your soul, and everything else after that. Like, what are some tips that you have for us?
Sure. So I think a good way to think about this is, one, you're never done learning. I remember like being with Minnesota Vikings, there was a guy named Jared Allen who's like eventually gonna be a Hall of Famer, like an awesome player. And this is someone who was probably like year 9 or 10 into his career. So like definitely an established veteran. And literally every single day, didn't matter how much money he was making or what his stats were, like at the end of every practice, perfecting his like go-to moves and go-to strategy. And the reason for that is because he wanted to be the best as he could at that. So a lot of what I've done has been like very focused on like what my strengths are. Like, I'm really process driven. I was the kind of person that, like, if I could create a schedule for myself and have a good understanding of how to win with that schedule, it's constant optimization. And I knew that was my strength, versus some people who are like really good on phone or really good at email or really good at social. Like, what I encourage all SDRs to do is like to really like either ask your manager or take a strong look at yourself and identify like, what's the thing that I can win at, or what's the one thing that I feel like I can do better than anyone else on our team, and how am I going to find a way to perfect that skill? And once you've kind of identified that, just relentlessly attacking it and finding ways to win consistently with it. And that's kind of honestly what I did. I can openly say, you know, my first quarter as an SDR, I tanked it. I had like 50% quota attainment. It's because I was still trying to figure that out. I was trying to figure out my motion. But once I started realizing how I could win after that, consistently my number kept getting higher and higher, and I just didn't turn back after that.
So how have these perspectives now shaped the way you think being a director now? So obviously, like they say, the higher up you go, the less control that you actually have. You're responsible for the people who are responsible. So obviously different tactic and approaches that go in line there. But can you walk us, now you're like a coach of a football team, if you think about it. So like, what are some tactics there from a coach's perspective that you've learned through your experience within the NFL?
Yeah, definitely. And again, the similarities, like I can think back to being on certain teams that had a ton of talent, but we just didn't win games, versus some teams who had almost not any talent at all, who would crush everyone else. And a lot of that just kind of geared towards the culture that you create in the team and kind of how people operate together. And I know it's like cliche and people talk about culture and teamwork and camaraderie, but that stuff is really important. And I think one thing, even for, I'll talk kind of about like myself as a leader, what I focus on, but even for SDRs in the team, like you don't have to be a team lead or be that person who's been on the team for, you know, a year or two, whatever it may be. Everyone has the opportunity to step in and be a leader. And I really focus on making sure that everyone understands like what our culture is within our team. How do we win together? And I'm like always reinforcing that, because I know fundamentally from my experience in the NFL that if you have a strong culture, you have really good processes in place and really good coaching to make sure everyone understands what they can do, that you'll always keep winning. So
game over.
It's game over, exactly. And so that's why I focus so much on that. It's our culture cannot be compromised. And as long as we have really strong systems in place to help people who want to learn and make sure that we're enabling everyone with the right resources to continue to grow, then can't be stopped.
Love that. Ernest, for anyone that has just been inspired by your wise words here, either, you know, a former athlete, whether that be at the high school, collegiate, or even the professional level, or just someone, you know, who's interested in like considering a role in tech sales, like what advice do you have for them?
Yeah, sure. And it's kind of, so people who are trying to get into this, and I can say this, like I was intimidated at first. Like I remember, I don't know what API was or B2B pipeline. Pipeline to me was like plumbing. It had nothing to do with it. It had nothing to do with sales. So like I think people get really intimidated by all the jargon, and some people look super savvy and they like talk really well. And if I could give anyone kind of advice on that, it's like these are all skills. These are all learnable skills.
Trainable skills, yeah.
Exactly. And though you might not know right now, if you do care about this and dedicate yourself to it, to perfecting your craft, you will get there. And I can honestly say that, you know, I literally had just finished playing football and like knew nothing about digital marketing, but I learned it. And I got really good. I got really good at communicating to people. And that's one of the alluring things about, I almost said play football. That's one of the alluring things about being in sales. It's because everything can be learned and you can always make yourself better as long as you're aware of what your strengths are and how you can grow.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Such inspiring words, Ernest. I guess for anyone out there that, you know, has just been inspired and wants to pick your brain either at, you know, potential opportunities and partnerships at Sixth Sense, or just, you know, ask you a couple questions, where can they find you?
Yeah, definitely. So check me out on LinkedIn. I'm also on Twitter, but more so on LinkedIn. And honestly, I respond to people. So if you have questions about getting into tech or about being an SDR, BDR, or trying to find ways to grow, please don't hesitate to reach out to me, Ernest Owusu. I think / Ernest Owusu, my full name. So just look out for me. And surprisingly, we'll say there are actually a lot of Ernest Owusu. So look for the one that says retired NFL athlete on the headline. But again, more importantly, I'm on LinkedIn and I want to help, because I understand what it's like to kind of try and navigate this and break into tech, as well as even trying to progress yourself as an SDR, and I'm really passionate about it, so I want to be able to be a resource for you.
Thanks so much for sharing your story, Ernest. We really appreciate it. Sales Dev Squad, I hope you guys found this helpful. Please check them out on LinkedIn. You're also on Twitter, correct?
Correct. Twitter, the Ernest Owusu. That's what it is.
All right. Well, please connect with the Ernest Owusu on LinkedIn and Twitter. You guys won't want to miss it. There's a lot of interesting posts lately as well. But Sales Dev Squad, hope you guys found this helpful, and we will catch you on the next one.